the easiest way possible. If you're making 6 crowns, it's easy. In the end, it saves time.
Hi, and welcome back to Onika Dental Show, where we discuss interesting cases and new procedures in the field of dentistry. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow us to stay tuned up to date. With us today, as always, is Dr. Yaniv. Hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Amazing. How are you?
Next question.
What did you bring for us today?
Well, today we brought a case that is not connected to implants at all. Just wanted to show different kind of techniques for frontal teeth, for aesthetical parts. And here you can see patient fell on his teeth and broke a couple of teeth. Probably these two teeth need a root canal treatment and a crown. This one you can restore with composite material. Now, in this case, what we want to do is to show how we're doing it in the clinic, the easiest way possible, and getting the end result as good as possible. Because the problem in the aesthetical parts, in cases when you need only to make one crown, for example, is that this crown have to be similar as the other teeth. And it's very hard to color the crown to look the same, exactly the same.
If it's only one.
If you're making 6 crowns, it's easy. Because in the lab, or the technician, or the doctor can make all the glaze. And when you're doing it in one shot, you get all the same colors. But if you want to make one tooth that will look like all the other tooth, it's quite hard. So the first thing that we did, we prepared both of the teeth. You can see in here that you can see the nerve of the teeth, of the tooth, and the other tooth, you can also see the nerve. You have a broken part of the tooth that just need to take out. Mm-hmm. Later on, when we started to analyzing the case, we saw that tooth 11 also needed tooth canal treatment, mm-hmm, because you had the break was quite deep. We prepared the teeth, we scanned the teeth, and while the technician made provisional crowns, we made the tooth canal, the root canal treatments. So in the end, after, for example, 2-3 hours, the technician gave us 3 crowns in one small bridge, and the patient was after all the root canal treatments. So now you want to wait for the gingiva to heal, you want to wait for to have some continuity in this case. You need to see how these teeth react. Maybe you'll have some kind of problem with one of the teeth. So in most cases, probably you want first of all make provisional crowns, gave it some time to heal. After we made the provisional crowns, we took again impressions and made the post and core for each tooth separately. We cemented the post and core, as you can see. They also made from zirconia, because you need to have aesthetic post and core. You don't want to have with a metal post and composite.
So it won't be thin through the crown?
Yeah, because the crowns for anterior teeth are translucent. Mm-hmm. You want all materials to be white, to be in the same color. So in this case, we use the zirconia cores. You can also make from a composite material, mm-hmm, and a fiberglass post. Then we took impressions on the post and cores, and we prepared zirconia crowns. Now, in here you can see the crowns, the after the glaze, after the whole process. The main problem when you're cementing crowns is the residues of the cement that will get stuck between the teeth, or under the between the crown and the gingiva. Mm-hmm. So before we cemented the crowns, you can't, because it's a bridge, you can't get with some kind of tool to clean the residues of the cement. So before cementing, we take a dental floss and we turn around the crowns where the residues of the cement are going to be. This way we can later on use the floss to clean between the crowns and then slowly taking it out.
So you use this, then you cement, then you take it out.
Exactly.
And then you don't have cement.
Yeah, then I don't have cement. I light cure the cement a little bit.
So you won't have cement at all?
Yeah, you won't have residues of the cement between the crowns and the gingiva. You can clean quite easily because you already have a floss between the crowns and the gingiva, so you just move it from one side to another, clean in different sides of adjacent to different crown to each tooth. And you can see also that the color of the crown is very similar to his own teeth. Mm-hmm. What we did is all the glazer part we made in our clinic. The patient came to us, and we just colored the crown with glazer.
In the clinic,
yeah.
You didn't send it to a technician?
I didn't send it to a technician because you can think that it takes a lot of chair time, but every time the patient comes to you, and then you send the patient to the laboratory, and then you get the crowns, and then you check the color of the crowns, and you write to the technician, you send the technician, and all of this process is just sometimes easier to take the glazer itself and apply a little bit of glaze on the crowns and color the crowns yourself.
But you need special equipment for it.
You need just an oven, that's all, and the glaze. It comes in colors, just color the crown and that's all.
So to do it, you just need to have an oven and a glaze?
Yeah, very simple.
It's some standard oven.
Standard oven for a glaze, yeah.
No,
not like you have in the kitchen.
No, I didn't. But tell me, it's expensive or it's something that it's like?
No, it's quite affordable. Every technician have it, so every doctor can have it also.
So it's worth having this oven in the kitchen. Just
in
saves
my
you
opinion,
a lot of time.
Yes, it takes you a little bit of time, but you get a very good result, and you can get it in the first shot. So.
It's something that the doctors know how to do, like you don't need special training to use.
There are a lot of courses. Every company have its own courses on how you apply glaze on crowns and what you do and how you do it without different types of techniques. You can even see it on YouTube.
So this procedure...
You can see us also on YouTube.
Thank you. So this procedure is... You say, like, if keeping this glaze coloring procedure at home, It's more comfortable.
It's more comfortable. In the end, it saves time. Mm-hmm. And you get...
The best result that you want.
The best result that you want.
Because you do it on the fly.
Exactly. This is the end result.
Why was it important to not have cement residues in the middle lane?
Because you can see them.
It's something that you want to see?
You'll see. It's the most important part is... the residues of the cement that goes between the crown and the gingiva. This is the residues that the cause of inflammation of a lot of these different problems. And this we clean with the dental floss. And
the color looks the same.
Yeah, the color looks the same. Everything looks great.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for being with us today. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and follow us to stay up to date. Thank you and have a great week.